So guys, today we are starting a new series of videos on my channel. The idea is to review for you one of the most iconic fragrances that has ever existed and share with you some modern alternatives. And we are gonna begin with Mitsuko, legend from Girlland that has been around for 100 years. So without further ado, if you are a big fan of this classic perfume and you're looking for some modern alternatives, I hope you will find this video helpful, and to learn more, please keep on watching. Hello everyone, welcome back on my channel. I'm really excited to finally film this video because I've been researching and looking for Mitsuko-like perfumes, and I have a top 5 list of such beautiful, unique, at the same time, Mitsuko-like fragrances to share with you, which are all from my most favorite indie brands. But before we get started with them, let's talk about the one that was created and never forgotten since then, Mitsuko by Guerlain. And I have this decant from Royalty Scents because I need to be honest with you, I wasn't feeling like investing into a full-size bottle because I've never been a fan of Mitsuko until I found these fragrances we'll be discussing in this video that made me think about Mitsuko, but I like them more than this fragrance, and I will explain you why. But before I do that, let me know how you feel about Mitsuko. How is it for you? This is definitely a challenging fragrance for the modern noses. I think it is pretty mature and maybe a bit less wearable than it was when it was first created in 1919 by Jacques Guerlain. And he was apparently inspired by the novel La Bataille, The Battle, that was written by his French writer Claude Ferrer. And the story is really heartbreaking. So the heroine in there, who is called Mitsuko, she is the wife of this Admiral Togo, right? And she's secretly in love with the British officer aboard the flagship of the Japanese fleet during the 1905 war between Russia and Japan. And so this beautiful Japanese lady Mitsuko awaits with dignity the outcome of the battle, nobly overcoming her feelings. And it's basically this love triangle. It is about heartbreak, it is about pain. And that's basically how Mitsuko smells to me, summed up, but I'll tell you more about the notes, the actual scent. But it's pretty heavy, it's pretty intense. There is like pain and love and tragic story going on in here. So since it has always reminded me of very old fragrances, and I don't mean old-fashioned, I mean like really old, and that makes sense, it's 100 years old, you know. I just wasn't feeling like buying a full-size bottle, although probably one day, once I am more mature, like this fragrance, you know, sometimes you really need to get there. So I hope one day I'll get myself a bottle of this perfume that of course has been already reformulated lots of times during the time. It probably will be, so now is probably the best time to get a bottle. Unfortunately, I have no experience with the original vintage formula. If you own one bottle of that, do let us all know how it smells. I can review Eau de Parfum that I got from Royalty Scents, that is a decant company, and they offer so many different perfumes. You can choose from popular designer and niche fragrances, and when I saw that they also have Mitsuko in their catalog, I was like, yes, this is the one that I will get. So definitely subscribe for a fragrance subscription, and you'll be able to explore so many different perfumes every month. Link is going to be below for you. But with that being said, let's talk about Mitsuko and how it actually smells. So this is definitely a vintage perfume. I have the dry down inside, and the more I wear it, the more I like it. But I have to tell you a few stories about it, and if you have a story about Mitsuko, do let us all know it in the comments. I want to refresh it just like a little bit. I don't really know where, because I've already sprayed all these 6 perfumes we'll be talking about on myself earlier today, but I'll do it again. Oh yes, you spray it on and it's powerful vintage perfume. Mitsoko is Shipra, and Shipra is perfume in which you have bergamot and oak musk. You get a lot of bergamot from Mitsoko and also very generous dose of oak musk. So other than bergamot, there are other citrusy notes, but all of them are pretty deaf, if that makes sense. You know, they are pretty, they're not sparkling and fresh and light and, you know, like uplifting. They have lots of power and spiciness is actually very noticeable on me personally. Mitsoko is definitely about one very special note that I used to be obsessed with last month, and I'm still is actually. Peach, and my obsession with peach in the perfumery made me fall in love with Mitsoko that I used to be like scared by in the past. So basically, Jacques Guerlain, he revolutionized Coty's Shipra formula by adding this peach note to it, peach aldehyde. It's called C14, if I'm not wrong. So anyway, we have here peach, but if you expect a very fruity, fun, citrusy and fresh kind of Shipra from Mitsoko, that's not necessarily what it is about. To me, it's rather about really dated floral notes that are almost dead, you know? We have ylang ylang and jasmine in there, so notes with indole, which has this kind of like dying, animalic twist to it. There was rose, there was orris root. You can tell that this is a very full-bodied, multifaceted fragrance that has also lots of spiciness to it. There is vetiver and amber, but of course oak musk is most dominant note in here. So peach is rather fuzzy, it's rather like a skin peach than this juicy and fun peach note. So overall, that's how it smells, but I think because it has been so popular for 100 years, this perfume smells like history now, and not necessarily like, you know, a list of notes. And that is how I feel about Mitsoko. Now, today, as my stepfather came home, he was like, "What's the smell?" So he didn't like it at all. He was like, if someone burned something or something similar to it, you know, hit something and burns. And I was like, wait, I have 6 perfumes going on, and he liked all of them except for Mitsoko. So it's probably not for everyone. Once again, it's probably for mature noses or for those who love serious, heavy, very like, fragrances with vintage vibe. I sense something like aldehydes in there that might come from that peach aldehydic note. And I'd like to know how you feel about Mitsoko. Do you find it wearable these days? If not, and you're looking for something that would be in that style, but a bit more wearable, a bit more modern, I have top 5 perfumes that are like that, and now we are moving on to them, because that's probably the most exciting part. And as I mentioned in the beginning of this video, all of these alternatives, but these are actually very unique perfumes on their own. I will explain you which similarities with Mitsoko I personally notice. They are from my favorite indie brands, and the first one I want to mention that is probably closest to Mitsoko I have here is by the French niche house Anatole Lavriton, and the fragrance is called Le Scandaleuse. By the way, I apologize myself for my French mispronunciation. If you're feeling like correcting me, do that in the comments. But now let's talk about this fragrance that hasn't been love at first sniff for me, but once my curiosity, you know, raised because of Mitsoko, I was like, oh, I remember this fragrance. So I'm very lucky to have it here. Oh, and the dry down is just marvelous. But let me spray it one more time on me. Oh my god, you have here leather. And I know Mitsoko is not about leather, but you have it here, which I really like, particularly with tuberose. It creates this dirty floral thing going on, which I'm a big fan of. It has ylang ylang, which has that, you know, like dated sensuousness to it. Of course, this is Shipra with lots of bergamot and oak musk, but you also have this peach note in there. And for me, ylang ylang, peach, oak musk and bergamot, that's kind of like the core of Mitsoko. So the vibe is in there, but with the leather and addition of this tuberose, carnal flower, it evokes this feeling of sexual desire, which I really like. Plus, there is note of artemisia, which brings in some greenery and kind of lifts it up. Mitsuko is pretty heavy fragrance, and in my opinion, this is way more wearable, but with absolutely undeniable vintage vibe. So I'm a big fan of this one. I find it's more pleasant, more easygoing, and even sexier than Mitsuko is. So I highly recommend you Le Scandaleuse. Scandalous fragrance for those who are feeling very, very bold but not ready, or kind of like moved on from Mitsuko to something a bit more, yes, with the leather, with a really cool, almost like powdered tuberose and leather. Beautiful addition to some of main Mitsuko notes by Anatoly. Right, so you know, Mitsuko offers so many different facets, and I like that all of my alternatives, they have focus on different aspects, main aspects of Mitsuko. And the next one is by the Canadian indie house Malik Perfumes, called Madeline Peach Number 7. And you guys, this fragrance is like Mitsuko, but it is so much more peachy than Mitsuko is. It is also way warmer and rounder than Mitsuko is. For me, Mitsuko is rather sharp and very cool, although spicy, yes, and animalic fragrance, and normally such perfumes are rather warm, but this one, it's truly warm. It's almost hot, and yes, very, very sexy. Indol is in there, coming from jasmine and ylang ylang, all the opulent flowers. You get them in here. You also have this aldehydic illusion that I notice about Mitsuko as well, but peach, oh my god, it's riper, it's more delicious and more pronounced in Mitsuko. Actually, I don't really smell a lot of peach in Mitsuko, so I really like that Matthew really put the accent onto the note of peach. So if you love that fruitiness of Mitsuko and you want more of that, but at the same time you want this rich and very expansive, sexy fragrance going on that would have Mitsuko character, but more peach to it, you know, more life. Ah, yes, that is it. With something warm, you know, like warm clothing, colder weather, going out, oh my god, everyone will pay attention to the way you smell, and you'll be definitely in the center of attention with this fragrance. But you really need to like also the vintage side of Mitsuko, which I find is prominent in all of these fragrances. Well, with a little exception, but not about this next one. Actually, this is another decant today, and this perfume is called The Lover's Tale by Francesca Bianchi. I got my decant from the amazing online niche boutique Ecuación Natural that is based in Spain, and you can choose from so many different amazing niche and indie brands there, so I definitely recommend you to visit their website and use my coupon code to save some money. And you can also find this fragrance there, which is pretty popular among Indian niche perfume lovers for good reason. This stuff, as the majority of Francesca Bianchi's perfumes, is so addictive. And there are a couple of similar notes to Mitsuko, but a lot of different ones. So I have the Drida here, and that's the prettiest part about this perfume. It's just to die for. It's different from Mitsuko, I can't call it prettier, but oh my god, this is very, very good. Full bottle worthy, although it is not easy to understand it. So let me spray it a little bit more. Oh my gosh, the opening is basically the most delicious, yummiest orris root note you can imagine, and leather. You get that leather once again that you also had in Le Scandaleuse, but these are very different perfumes. In here you got the tuberose and the freshness, the green aspect. It's a very interesting perfume too. I think if you like interesting fragrances that would smell classy and super sexy, you will love Le Scandaleuse. If you're looking for something a bit more erotic, with a bit more of animalic action going on, you will get it from here. If you know Francesca's signature, you will get it in here too. It's powdery, it's heavy, balmy, but there is peach in there and indolic flowers, and of course oak moss and bergamot, because this is a shipra, but shipra with kind of like sticky balms and honey that puts everything together. Peach in there is noticeable in the middle. In the opening, it's, oh, I'm Shipra, I'm bold, and this is a super sexy erotic lather that smells like hot lover skin, you know? But then it calms down, and in the dry down, true magic happens. This is the evolution of someone's love, you know, starting with sympathy and then huge sexual attraction and then true love. This is gorgeous animalic perfume with kind of like Mitsuko reference because of the peach and jasmine and, you know, like Shipra, but it's different. It's pretty different from Mitsuko. I just wanted to include it on this list because it's something addictive, something amazing, something for men and women, for those who are looking for a very erotic perfume with the vintage vibe. But once again, I can't stress that enough, all of these five alternatives, they are very, very modern. And with that being said, let's move on to the next one, which was actually the first I've ever owned that reminded me of Mitsuko, although it is probably least similar to it, and I'm talking about Poppy by DSH Perfumes, which, you know, is one of my most favorite indie houses ever of all times. And the thing is, it's also my perfect autumnal fragrance. It smells like harvesting, it smells very spicy. I feel like the accent is putting onto the spicy aspect of Mitsuko in here, although I'm not sure if Dawn even had Mitsuko on her mind while creating this fragrance that is spicy and delicious. It is pretty heavy on nutmeg and tobacco and clove. I know those notes are not in Mitsuko, but for some strange reason, I definitely smell some similarity with it. Although, if you smell them side by side, oh my god, they are like different perfumes. But that peach that we have here and in all of these fragrances, probably peach and Shipra for me, that is the Mitsuko association in each fragrance. And if you have any other on your mind that you are willing to share, maybe you know a Shipra with a peach, probably for me that would be a Mitsuko-like perfume, share it in the comments. I would say if you're looking for the least similar perfume to Mitsuko with peach and heavy balance and smoke and lots of oak moss and carnation, you know, it's very, very spicy and autumnal and just delicious, warm and cozy. Truly empowering perfume because these spices truly ground you and there is almost like a smoky background. And with that fuzzy skin peach note, it has the parallel with Mitsuko. And if you're looking for something autumnal like this, then that's Poppy by DSH Perfumes for men and women among you. Alrighty guys, to complete this video, I went with something more optimistic than Mitsuko is, because as I've already mentioned, it's full of tragedy. To me, it is very serious and heavy Shipra, and my blind buy that I made for this video, which is Paris 1948 by 4000 High Resisted Tuesdays, is definitely the most easygoing and the happiest Shipra I know, with similar notes to Mitsuko. That's why I wanted to have it for this video. But it is very different from it, because Mitsuko is heavy, it is quite deep and even dark, very mysterious. And this one, it is so flirty, it is so fun. The peach note in there is so much different from Mitsuko. It is juicier, you know, it's very sparkling, and there is serious citrus explosion in the opening. There is note of grapefruit, which is bitter and so ripe and delicious and yummy. There is note of basil that brings in something new into this Shipra, which has Sarah McCartney's signature written all over it and almost like a bubblegum twist, which I like so much about it, because this is very everyday friendly but also special occasion time appropriate Shipra for those who are getting into this Shipra celebration party but slowly and are looking for something less scary than Mitsuko is, but still with its touch. And that is definitely this one. I love it, and what's great about it, it is very versatile and you can wear it day and night in any weather, which is so cool, and I can't tell that about every of these. So guys, on that note, that completed this video, which I sincerely hope you enjoyed watching, particularly if you are looking for some Mitsuko alternatives. And since it was longer than my usual videos and you got a lot of information, I want to quickly sum it up for you. And so Mitsuko is this legendary, classy Shipra perfume with additional peachy note, but it is spicy and very mossy and smells quite old-fashioned, particularly to me personally. That's why I love these modern alternatives more. And the closest to it is Luz Candelu, blues with additional dirty floral leather element, and still there is that peach note that we had in Mitsuko and some green element, which is very sexy, and I truly love this classical powdered magic. But if you want more fruitiness and more sweetness in your Mitsuko, then I recommend you Madeline Peach number 7, because it has this overripe peach note with indoles. It's very sexy and quite hot because of the musk. So this is something very sexy and truly, truly peachy. But if you like that spicy side of Mitsuko and you want even more of it with the peach, then that is Poppy by DSH Perfumes. And if you're looking for something more fresh, something more sparkling, more juicy, more fruity, just with more freshness and less heaviness than Mitsuko, that is 1948 Paris by 4000 Harris Institute Days. I can't even describe you how much I love it. It's a blind buy, love at first sniff for me. But of course, if you're looking for something truly animalic with sexual attraction going on, that is La Rossella by Francesca Bianchi. Super amazing, sticky, sexy fragrance. But I would like to know which of these you like the most. What do you think about Mitsuko? Is it a timeless or old-fashioned perfume to you? Let me know how you would call this series. I'm looking for your ideas, your feedback, and also which superstar perfume you want to see featuring in the next episode. I'm looking forward to hear from you. Thank you so much for watching. Check out the description box. And on that note, we'll see each other in the next one. Bye, guys. By the way, I gotta be honest with you, Mitsuko evokes different colors in my head. Personally, I associate it with such autumnal muted green color and some sparkles of peach, red, muted orange and yellow. So my nails are kinda Mitsuko inspired as well. It is a truly autumnal perfume to me, but let me know how you feel about it. You know, Mitsuko has so many reasons to love and hate it. Let me know your opinion about it, because I find there is love and hate and nothing in between about Mitsuko. So guys, you know, as I am putting lights back on, I've realized something. All of these perfumes, they smell so amazing. And if Mitsuko is too vintagey, too old-fashioned to you personally, and you want something similar yet different to it, with unique character, unique DNA, but something that will remind you just a little bit with one aspect or another of Mitsuko, check out my alternatives. They are pretty damn good and daring. That is what all of them have in common. So guys, while editing this video, I got a question to you. How can you describe this phenomenon of Mitsuko? Because it has been around for such a long period of time, and during this time it has been worn and loved by so many people and also Hollywood stars. So I'm wondering, is it still relevant in your opinion? Because I gotta be honest with you, I prefer my alternatives.